So this shoe cost me $420. That's not a joke. That's actually how much I spent on it. What's up, everybody? I'm Seth Fowler, and today I'm reviewing the Golden Goose Superstar. So I'm sure if you follow high-end fashion, you probably already know who Golden Goose is. However, if you're like me and you're kind of dumb when it comes to fashion, you just think it's a beat-up superstar, which, I mean, it kind of is. So to fill you in on who Golden Goose is, they're a Venetian designer brand that started back in 2000. Their signature style, at least from what I can tell, is sort of pre-worn and pre-distressed looks. And something that I found out when I was researching this company is that they're actually very, very selective about who can actually sell their products. It might look like a beat-up pair of Stan Smiths, but you will never find this at a place that sells things that aren't premium. And as I mentioned before, this shoe cost me $420 brand new, and that's pretty much the standard price for their sneakers, which is kind of surprising when your shoe looks like this. Actually, I got a pair of Adidas Stan Smiths that came out last summer. I think they retailed for $120, and this is their more premium Stan Smiths. And I bet you if you wore this shoe for like 6 months, you could get it to look like this for a lot cheaper. But that's neither here nor there, because you're not buying this shoe because of how it looks, you're buying it because of the brand name associated with it. And that's sort of just the common denominator with really high-end fashion. Yes, some of it looks really great, but other stuff just looks kind of weird, and the reason people buy it is because it has the brand name on it. With that said though, I do have to admit that I actually kind of do like the way this sneaker looks, and to be honest, I wouldn't have bought this if it wasn't for the video, but I do kind of understand the appeal, at least a little bit. It is definitely a polarizing look though, and I know a lot of people out there probably hate the way this sneaker looks, but at the end of the day, it's really just up to your own personal preference. But looks aside, man, $400 is a huge amount of money. And at the end of the day, is this sneaker actually worth it? Let's find out. Jumping into the toe of the sneaker, you've got this white leather, which is obviously already pre-creased, and you've also got this distressed or I guess scuff mark on the toe. Moving back in the shoe, you've got more white leather panels around the eyelets, and then weaving through these eyelets, you've actually got these pre-dirtied gray laces. I don't think they're actually dirty. I think they've just been sort of dyed to make them look like they're dirty, but you know, it gives you that same sort of aesthetic. I don't know, man, this is really weirding me out. I don't really get that high-end designer stuff. I don't know. It's not bad, it's just weird. Underneath the dirty laces, you've got this white leather tongue that has GGDB debossed into it. Obviously, it means something like Golden Goose, that boy, I don't. Or maybe it stands for good game because they got me to spend $420 on this shoe. I don't know. Moving inside the shoe, you've got this dark navy leather sock liner, which actually feels pretty decent on foot because it's padded pretty nicely around the ankle. And then the insole of the shoe comes in white leather with the Superstar logo printed on the heel and the DB emblem embossed into the toe. Interestingly enough, this insole is super thick towards the heel, but the foam is really, really stiff. And also for some reason, they added this really hard plastic bit in the heel, which actually kind of makes this shoe relatively uncomfortable. To be honest, I mean, that's just the way that I felt about it. I mean, maybe it's different on you. Maybe you like harder heels, I don't know. But I gotta be honest, it's just a really weird way to construct an insole of a shoe. I'm just not sure exactly why they would do that. I'm sure there's a reason. I don't know what that reason is. Maybe it's because it's cheaper. Maybe it's because it's some sort of designer thing to do. I have no idea. I will say that it is kind of hard to get this insole back inside the shoe. There we go. That sound sucks. As for sizing and fit, I grabbed a size 42, which is a size 9 US men's, and I've gotta be honest, it does fit a little bit big, so if I had the chance to do it over, I would probably go with a size 8.5. There's just not a lot of padding in the upper, and it's also got a pretty wide ankle area, so I found my heel slipping out more than I would have liked. But as I always suggest, if you have the chance to try this shoe on first before you buy it, make sure to do that to make sure you're grabbing the right size for you. As you move back on the sneaker, you get to this gray suede star, which seems to be pretty common on Golden Goose sneakers. Maybe it's their logo, I'm not exactly sure. Maybe it's just on the Superstars, I have no idea. Then just below the suede star, you've got some more of that white Italian leather, which from my point of view as someone who knows some about leather but not a huge amount, I would say that it seems decent. It's better than mass manufactured leather, but it's not incredible. Obviously the white finish on the leather is distressed, which is done even more on the medial side than on the lateral side. It's not that heavily distressed though to where I can feel a texture change between the white areas and the distressed areas, but it just seems like they rubbed off the top layer of paint. Printed on the midfoot of the lateral side, you've got the GGDB S Star logo, which I'm assuming stands for Golden Goose Superstar or Golden Goose Dat Boy Superstar. I don't know why I keep doing that. It's so stupid. Does it mean designer brand? Also on both sides of the shoe, you've got three perforations. On the lateral side, it's kind of angled upwards, and on the medial side, it's right in the midfoot. Then continuing back on the shoe to the heel, you get to this really glossy navy blue leather, and just below that, you've got more of that gray suede. Then moving down on the shoe, you get to this very heavily distressed sort of yellow vulcanized midsole. It almost looks like someone skated in this midsole. Actually, that's a cool idea. Having a shoe that's been pre-skated in, maybe that's been done before, I don't know. Let's be honest though, they probably just went up against the belt sander and that was about it. And then finally, moving to ironically the cleanest and newest looking part of the shoe, you've got this gum herringbone outsole. So now at this point in the video, I guess it's time to answer the question, is this shoe worth $420? And in my opinion, absolutely not. But at the end of the day, the people who are buying this shoe are not buying it because they think it's worth it, they're buying it because of the brand name and they think the brand name is worth it. So if you're someone who really likes this shoe and likes the brand and is willing to spend $420, great, that's up to you, it's your money. Would I personally recommend spending that much money on a shoe that looks like a Stan Smith that's been worn for 6 months? Probably not, but let's be honest, as a sneakerhead, you've probably spent more on resale on shoes that are probably worse quality than this one. But now I would love to know your thoughts on the Golden Goose Superstar and whether you'd ever consider grabbing a pair for yourself. So let me know in the comment section down below. And as always, thank you so much for watching. Make sure to subscribe if you haven't yet, and I'll see you all in the next one.